Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube. Now, in the previous video, we looked at the west end of the ArcelorMittal Coke plant, and now we're going to take a look at the east end. As we pull back, we see two rows of empty hoppers, and we also notice the various color differences on the roof of this mill building. Now, often in modeling, we do have a tendency to paint our roofs all one color, but looking at the prototype, it shows that this isn't always the case. On the east end is where the byproducts take place. But looking once again at that building, it's not just the roof that has the different colors. You could see a lot of the repairs over the years, and it creates a very interesting looking building. In this really cool shot, we get to see that the walls are really a patch job of sheet metal and various stages of rust. Here we see where the conveyor belt is going to put the coal into the top of the coaling tower. The coal will then go into a larry car. The larry car will move along and it will deposit coal into the top of each one of the ovens. Then the lids are put back on and the coal is heated for about 16 hours. When all the impurities are burned off and it becomes hot coke, then the pusher, which we see right here, is on this side. It pushes the hot coke through the oven onto the other side into a waiting quench car. The quench car will move the hot coke underneath this black structure. That is called a quenching tower. And that is where tons of water will be sprayed onto the car to cool off the red hot coke. And when this process takes place, you will see a lot of steam in the air. So now we're going to gradually move over towards the Monongahela Riverside. We're going to try to keep the camera's focus on the batteries. And you can see the pusher. There's a big arm on that pusher that pushes the coke through the batteries. You'll notice that there is safety yellow painted everywhere. This was filmed on July 3rd, the last operating day. The plant went into hot idle because business slowed down due to COVID. Hopefully this is just temporary. Get a nice view of the top of the coke ovens. This is a view you're really not going to see from the town of Monesson. We'll try to get another look at the quenching tower. Look at the roof of it. That's where all the pipes for all the water to spray down onto the car. A lot of fun details to model if you're building the coke plant made by Walther's. And this is the byproduct side. And normally at night, when the byproducts are being made, you will see the large flames in the air coming from the top of these, we'll just call them stacks. All right, so another look at the top of a quench tower. Pretty slick. Modeling coke facilities are just a lot of fun. You can really get creative. Add a lot of fun details. And this was perfect weather, beautiful sunlight. And I'm glad that I was able to film this for you guys. So hopefully this gave you some more ideas and inspiration. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, DJ's Trains, please do so, and you can also follow me on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. I have more videos coming up. I've done a lot of filming, despite working my butt off with CSX. Now, I have done videos on how to paint a steel mill. That's a very popular video with some really cool ideas. So you can check out my playlist under steel mills. I could really use your help. I just don't feel like I'm getting the views that I would like. And so I ask that you start sharing some of my videos on your Facebook or Twitter or just through any social media, through message boards. I just feel like I have a lot of good videos that would help people with their modeling. So if you can share, it's greatly appreciated. Thanks.